Welcome to the online session of Power Plant Engineering. My name is Vishal Acharya. Today we will discuss about the low flare boiler, SCMI Hamilton boiler and supercritical boiler and supercharged boiler. First is the low flare boiler. The main working principle of the low flare boiler here, the produce of the superheated steam, 2/3 steam is used in an evaporating drum here. And 1/3 steam is transferred to the turbine to for the produced work. The main device here is feed pump for the circulating the water in an economizer. Economizer is device to increase the temperature of the feed water. Here evaporating drum. In an evaporating drum, 2/3 superheated steam passed through the nozzle and mixing with the feed water and convert into the saturated steam. Here steam circulating pump, here the production of the saturated steam is transferred to the radiant superheater by the help of the steam circulating pump. Here radiant superheater heat transfer from the combustion of the fuel by the radiation and convert into the super steam. And the convective superheater here, the steam is converted into the superheated steam at 500 degrees Celsius and transferred to the steam to the turbine, and the 2/3 steam is transferred to the superheated steam. The main working of the low flare boiler here, the water is transferred from the feed pump for the higher pressurized to the economizer. In a economizer, feed water temperature increase and transfer to the evaporating drum. In a evaporating drum, 2/3 superheated steam here spray by the help of the nozzle and mere mixing the superheated steam and the feed water so that the feed water getting the heat by the directly contact with the superheated steam. So here feed water is converted into the saturated steam. Saturated steam is passed through the radiant surface superheater by the help of the steam circulating pump here. In a radiant superheater, the steam temperature increased by the heat transfer action of the combustion fuel by the help of the radiation. And then radiant surface evaporator passed through the convective superheater. In a convective superheater, convert the steam at the 500 degree Celsius temperature and then transfer to the 2/3 here in evaporating drum and 1/3 here main steam supply. The advantage of the low flare boiler is the evaporator tube in the boiler carries the superheated steam here so that here no salt deposition means the corrosion of the boiler is very less. Here boiler are very compact in the design. Here high steam generating capacity. The boiler is suitable for the marine application. Here and this type of boiler is always used for the marine application. Next is the SCMI Hamilton boiler. The main working principle here, the two circuit here. First is the primary circuit here. Here secondary circuit. In a primary circuit we use the distilled water, and in a secondary circuit here we use the on water, means the simply water, not any feed water treatment. In a primary circuit, the pressure of the steam is above the 100 bar, and in a secondary circuit here, the pressure only the 50 to 60 bar. First, the water is transferred from the water drum to the primary coil. Means in a primary evaporator, here water is converted into the higher pressure and approximately 100 bar and transferred to the water drum. Then steam is supplied to the air secondary drum. The secondary drum passes through the tubes and higher pressurized steam heat supply to the lower pressurized steam means the our impure water. Then is impure water is converted into the steam and passed to the superheater. Here in a primary coil convert to the saturated steam by the help of the fuel gases. So here the work of the primary, first in a water drum to the evaporator, increase the temperature, then pass through the steam separator drum. In a steam separator drum, pass through the here in a tubes. Here in a tube, high pressurized tube, pass heat transfer to the lower pressure, means the simple water and converted into the steam. Here high pressurized steam is converted into the low pressurized steam and passed through the feed preheater. In a free preheater, heat transfer to the lower pressure water or impure water, then is converted into the saturated steam or saturated or wet steam and passed to the air. And feed pump supply to the water in a feed water. So here this is the working of the Scheimidt Hermantin boiler. Here the main device is the feed pump, evaporator coil, steam separator, steam generator and feed preheater, and the air is transferred from the air preheater to the air furnace. This is the two circuit boiler. So here main is the overheating problem is solved and the salting problem means the some corrosion problem in a tube is solved by the two circuit. Is only the boiler where two circuit are operated. First circuit is the distilled water and second circuit is the impure water. The advantage of the Scheimidt Hermantin boiler is the salt deposition in the evaporating drum is easily brushed off, meaning the air corrosion problem is solved. No problem of overheating because the air two circuit are operated, so overheating problem is very less. Take the wide fluctuation of the load. Here steam generation capacity is variable, so here we operate the load without priming the water take place in the evaporator. Here no requirement the priming action because only water is transferred from the watering drum. So this is the main advantage of the Scheimidt Hermantin boiler. Our next boiler is the in a supercritical boiler. In a supercritical boiler, here same principle used in our Benson boiler. Here higher pressure water is transferred. Higher pressure water means the supercritical pressure. In a supercritical water means the here no latent heat. Here water is directly converted into the saturated water to the superheated steam. So here no require any heat exchanger before the pass through the boiler. Here feed water is transferred to the convective surface and then transfers to the radiant surface, and in a convective surface is converted into the saturated water and saturated steam. Saturated steam passed to the radiant superheater, and radiant superheater from the radiant superheater here heat absorbed by the hot gases and converted into the superheater steam to supply to the turbine, and air preheater supply to the here for the furnace. So here the directly here water is converted into the superheated steam or saturated steam in a economizer and then radiant superheater. This is the basic principle of the supercritical boiler, same principle as a Benson boiler. Already we have discussed about the Benson boiler. The advantage of the supercritical boiler, here heat transfer rate are large compared to the subcritical boiler. There is no drum. This is an advantage because space required is less. Heat capacity of generator and is stable for a better response. There is a no two-phase mixer and hence the problem the erosion and corrosion are minimized here. Here, supercritical boiler can be generate the peak load by charging the pressure of the operation. This is the main advantage. The great ease operation and their comparative simplicity, flexibility made and adapted by the load fluctuation. Here, the water pressure is the required main factor for the fluctuation. Here, high thermal efficiency. Here, the expensive metal is required for the design of the tube boiler is very high pressurized. So, here required the expensive material. The additional problem is created due to the separation of the solid impurity as a phase changes. The solid remain in the tubes and the block the passage of the flow of the feed water. So, it's necessary to treat water throughoutly before the supply to the steam. Next boiler is a supercharged boiler. In a supercharged boiler, here we use the gas turbine. Here, produce process of the gas turbine. Here, surrounding air enter from into the compressor. Compressed air transfer to the furnace. Here, produce the hot gas is passed through the boiler tubes and the superheater, and hot gas is then passed through the gas turbine and produce the some work and then transfer the exhaust gases in economizer for the feed water heating. This is the basic principle of the supercharged boiler. Here, the main principle or working principle of the supercharged boiler here. The water is supplied into the economizer by the help of the feed pump. Here, economizer increase the temperature of the water by the help of the gas turbine exhaust steam or gases. Then, economizer water is feed water is transferred to the boiling tube. In a boiling tube, here temperature of the boiler tube is increased and then is converted into the saturated steam. Then pass to the boiler drum. Here in a boiler drum, when the is converted into the dry steam, then pass to the superheater and converted into the superheated steam by the help of the hot gases here. And then some water particle is not converted into the dry steam, then again return to the boiler tube and then pass to the boiler tubes and converted into the steam. Here the hot gases is transferred to the gas turbine and here compressor is running by the gas turbine. This is the basic principle of the supercharged boiler and working. The main devices is gas turbine, compressor, boiler tube, steam drum, superheater, economizer. This is the main device for the supercharged boiler. Advantages is it requires a less heat transfer surface due to the small heat capacity of the boiler and boiler plant gives the better response to control. Here to restart of the boiler is possible. The part of the gas turbine output can be used to the driver the other auxiliary. Means the we use the gas turbine power plant is a main any mechanical work and also used for the power supply. Comparatively less number of the operations is required. And the main disadvantage is required the tight pressure for the high pressure gas. This is the disadvantage of the supercharged boiler. Thank you.